how you see the world that's different from how everyone else sees the world, that's why you're an artist. That's your purpose in sharing your work with the world.
Astral World's been set in stone since rodeo. So my whole idea was like, if you locked in the rodeo, then definitely locked in the Astral. It's like, I'm just finishing the saga I started on my first album. You know what I mean?
This is no longer something that should be considered, but viewed as an essential piece in the music making process. Music should be an in-depth experience. And if this is executed correctly, it can take your album experience to the next level and separate yourself from the pack. This is world building, and it's the future of music. All right, welcome in. Just tried something new with the intro. Let me know what you guys think. I'm going to try out some more stuff, see what works, what doesn't. But the real reason of why I wanted to do this video is because of the new Don Toliver project. And he hasn't done it before, but I feel like he did a great job of embodying world building throughout this entire course of the rollout. And then you hear it within the project itself, like how it inspired. But before we get into the specific examples, because I'm going to go into a few artists of ones who have been extremely successful with world building and some who, for better or worse, like could have pissed off their fans or whatever, who haven't been as successful in world building, but still do it. But before we get into those specific examples, let's dive into the elements of what world building actually is. First, visual aesthetics, album art, social media rebrand. You even see at some point where the person goes through an entire rebrand. You kind of think of what I think of right away is like the Weeknd, how he turns into these different characters every single time that he starts this like new feeling of an album rollout. He turns into like almost a completely different person and just like really embodies it. It's honestly impressive. Next, merchandising, clothing line, themed products around this. Something big that Travis Scott does on his website. He crushes it every single time. And then next, storytelling. And this is not just through music, but through the overall art products and concepts itself. Is anybody can go ahead and drop some sort of merchandise, but if you're able to tell a product or a story through those products, it's going to make you stick out. And then next, why does this matter? For me, this matters a lot. I don't know about you guys. This helps create a unique identity and honestly memorable for your fans. Feeding your fans. I say this all the time. Like when we talk about music on this channel, it's like I appreciate when the artist takes time to like do more above and beyond to feed their fans outside of just the music. Next, engagement. Deeply integrating fans into like their lore and their world and giving them an inside look at like how they create, which I find pretty interesting. Gives the album more of a life cycle. It allows it to live on past just being an album itself. Something that you can think of right away is think of Astroworld and what the span of Astroworld was with the festivals, the music, the merchandise, everything around it. That album lived on for years and still living on to this day because of how great of a job he did branding it. Next thing too is it shows off the full scope of an artist. Like I understand wanting music and I appreciate the music. It's the most important part, but it also allows them to give an inside look into, like I said before, how they create, what they like, what they don't like. And I appreciate them giving like the fans an inside look at that and giving us an opportunity to get into that world and with like buying merchandise or a CD, a vinyl, whatever that might be. That's an important piece to me as well, because it's just, it has a different feeling when you're connected to it in a way. And lastly, it boosts revenue, multiple streams of income. It allows you to have a little bit more of a grandiose tour. That I always use Travis in this situation. He's the king of touring. Because you built that world, you built that merchandise, everything about it, and then you're giving it to your fans and they're buying it, and that's multiple streams of income. So that's why it matters. Helps create a unique identity, engagement, gives the album more of a life cycle, shows off the full scope of the artist, and boosts revenue. And then now let's get into the individual artists of who have been extremely successful doing this. And I'm going to start with Travis Scott.
In the middle of Houston, Texas, is a world called Astroworld. Bring the whole family for thrilling rides, exciting adventures, and memories you'll cherish for a lifetime. Houston's premier...
The first artist that we're going to dive into is Travis Scott. And if anybody knows me who's watching this video, you know that I'm a massive Travis Scott fan, but I'm going to talk about multiple artists and don't want this video to be forever, so I'll keep it short. There's some key points in Travis Scott's rollouts of his world building. First, it becomes a heavy talking point for him. For example, the rodeo, Astroworld, Utopia. I want to go to Utopia. I want to go to Astroworld. He makes up this fake place, but it becomes a heavy talking point for him. Next, full aesthetic rebrands, which you can, each time that he drops an album, you start to feel a shift in him with his style, with how he's speaking, what he's posting on social media. He goes through a full rebrand and really embodies the art that he's putting out during that time period. Next, long-form music videos to tell a story of the music itself. He did this with Birds in the Trap, and he did this with like the Jack Boys. They did like a 15-minute short movie with like all of them like hanging out with like a showcase of all of the beats. Utopia, he did it with, he dropped an entire in-person movie like in the theater, which like an hour long, which was great. But you can tell that this long-form video of him, for him, is a big deal because he's made a point to do it the last few times that he's dropped a project. Next, application of physical production for the shows. For example, the bird floating for the Birds in the Trap sing McKnight. That was like the very first iteration of this, where it was small, but at the time it could have been viewed as big. Next, Astroworld, he had two roller coasters in the arena every single night when he was performing, which was ridiculous. And then if anybody went to the Utopia shows these last times, there was just like a weird, eerie feeling throughout the air at these places that felt just like his doing and his world that he wanted to portray. Next, the point that I have written down here is merch. I mean, Travis Scott's the merch king. He's great at it on his website, where he drops the high quality stuff. And then if you go to the shows, that it's getting sold out every single night. The lines are out the door trying to get their hands on some t-shirts. Also, when he's rolling out these projects, key brand deals, Audemars Piguet, McDonald's, Nike, Fortnite, being able to pair with some of the biggest brands in the world to complement your music as well makes you a lot more visible. And then on top of it, you're able to really crush those brand deals, and it makes everything better. So the music's really good, gets you put in a situation where you're collabing with these big brands, and these big brands are just lifting you up even more. I really think it starts with Astroworld with Travis Scott, where that was the first time where he was doing stuff before, but when it comes to collectively coming together and him really nailing the aesthetic, this was the first time that he did it, from the rollout, the sound of the album, and then the post-production of the album, whether that be touring, videos, or whatever, to really make it feel like that full Astroworld experience, where he had roller coasters at his shows, he was hosting Astrofest and all of these incredible events. And this is going to be a page that I think is taken out of his playbook. It'll never be recreated, because I don't think anybody could ever recreate the magnitude of what Astroworld was in this album and everything that he did with it, that world building that I was talking about. But I think that it's definitely something that people will pull pieces of, because the Travis Scott playbook for marketing yourself and rolling out a project and then the execution of the project itself, I think everybody's studying, because there's nobody in the business that does it better than him. And I don't really think that that's an argument to be had. I don't want to be too long on Travis because I'm extremely biased. The next person that I want to talk about, and it's just his character development, is The Weeknd. The next person that I want to touch on, and it's somebody who unfortunately, I'm just starting to really get into their music and kind of somewhat regret it a little bit, but that's the Weeknd. And something that I've noticed, and let me, this will be in a short segment, but something that kind of drew me into it is these characters that he's playing. And I'll pop it up on the screen here where, like, he kind of committed to this outfit that he wore for a long period of time, and he wore bandages all over his face. And then when he removed the bandages, he had like this over the top, like, plastic surgery done. And I don't know, I don't understand it really. So if you know what's going on in the comments, like, please let me know. But this is something where when I was thinking about the world building aspect of music, although I don't know a lot about the Weeknd, that's why I'm bringing this up, because his world building and character development is like so overwhelming that, like, you honestly, like, can't ignore it. And I know he's like the biggest artist in the world and like blah, blah, blah. But regardless, I'm not consuming a ton of his music, but every single time that he goes under one of these rebrands, it's one of the first things that I notice. So that's just one thing that I wanted to touch on very quickly, is how The Weeknd is able to captivate attention just based off of his character rebrands. And I think that that is another reason why he's special, and why I'm starting to get into his music now is, obviously, like I said, everything that we're going to lead back to, the music has to also be elite, and or these concepts and these like antics like won't match up, because people will be like, that's corny. But the way that he's executing along with high level music makes it flawless and makes it perfect. So just wanted to shout out The Weeknd real quick with his character development. The last person that we're going to be talking about is, for better or for worse, their world building exists, but it might be at detriment to them and their fans. And I was going to do Playboi Carti, because he's going through this whole thing where he's promising a lot but not living up to expectations. But thinking about it, the godfather of this, and my one of my favorite artists ever, is Frank Ocean. So my next person that I'm doing a deep dive on is Frank Ocean.
This apple appliance, you can capture live video.
The last artist on this video that I would like to dive into is Frank Ocean. Frank Ocean is the absolute definition of less is more, always allowing fans wanting more and some feeling that it's never enough. But you could tell that he has a complete understanding of how he wants his art and his music to be perceived, and he's completely comfortable with that. So there's a few things that stuck out to me through when I was thinking about how Frank Ocean world builds. And I kind of said it before this, where I was said, for better or for worse, because they promise so much, or they give a little bit of like a leak or a song or an Instagram story, and the fans go crazy because they have that core fan base, and the fans get frustrated at times because, like I said, it's never enough, because they are very particular about what they put out and how often they drop. And sometimes you might think that they might never drop again. And Frank Ocean is the embodiment of this. So the first thing that sticks out to me is how he communicates. He communicates through his website, whether that be like through photos, through like when he was promoting the rollout for Blonde and Endless, he posted a picture on his website of him holding two magazines, and it was a Tumblr post, and it said, "I got two versions." And then another post on his Tumblr was a library card that was stamped with like dates and would cross out and stamp a new date, and never lived up to any of those dates, which is hilarious. But I think it's interesting how Frank chooses to communicate through his website and Tumblr, not being in the limelight, not doing traditional media, but the real fans know kind of like where to find him. And if he ever does want to communicate with them, he's able to do that. So we look at Travis, who's very, I would say, over the top and wants to do so much and is in traditional media and has these big events and concerts and everything. And he's world building through a product and a made up concept in his head. And Frank Ocean is just world building through himself and his individuality and who he is as a person. Like, Frank Ocean is his world and his fans feel that way as well. So that is a polar opposite side of the situation, that it's interesting how we can look at somebody do something like a Travis Scott, who's extremely over the top with a made up concept, like, I want to go to Utopia. And then you look at somebody like The Weeknd, who is very big into character development, coming up with these characters, these crazy ideas that I, like I said, I don't really even understand, but I think it's cool. And then you look at somebody like Frank Ocean, who kind of world builds through himself and what he's able to put out just as an individual and not caring about anything else other than just the art. So yeah, the Frank Ocean topic is definitely one that has a lot of people like always talking, because you always wonder when he's going to drop next. But I'll tell you what, in 2016, if you were big into that music, it was, he had you eating out of the palm of his hands. Every single tiny post, anything, like, it was absolutely blown up on social media, the hype around the project and what he was able to do. And it lived up to the hype. I remember when the Endless live stream dropped, the group chats blew up, and it was like Frank Ocean just started a live stream on Apple Music. Like, we saw it on like Twitter, and it like stayed the same for like a week, that like infamous warehouse of a clip that you just saw. And what it turned into was a visual album where it rounded off of him like building a spiral staircase. And then legitimately the next day he drops Blonde with a music video for Nike's, which was flawlessly done. One of my favorite music videos of all time. And a beautiful album that completely was a crazy vibe that still in my rotation to this day. I have it on vinyl. It's one of my favorite albums ever. But being able to take you into kind of like his world a little bit, we were talking about this entire course of the video, where he's in a warehouse with these speakers and he's like woodworking, and it's like, what the fuck is this guy doing? He's so out of the limelight. Like, is this what he does? And then like more into it, where he's storytelling about all of his experiences that he's going through throughout the course of the time, where he doesn't give you a lot. I think it's like an hour long album, and I think the visual album's like 45 minutes, but that allows us to have Frank Ocean's world. And that's pretty much the last that we have of it since 2016. So rounding this out, and obviously this was a complete test of what I can do. And it was a little bit rushed. I just wanted to kind of do something and get it out. I don't want to think about it too much. I mean, that's kind of my motto for a lot of this stuff. But getting back into what I said originally, was what made this spark was Don Toliver. Don Toliver arrived this week in the music scene. He is extremely impressive. He isn't afraid to try things, which all of these guys that I've mentioned are not afraid to try things. Visually, aesthetically, sonically, through their music, through their fashion, through their videos, whatever that may be. And Don Toliver arrived on the scene this week and did the exact same thing. His rollout for his album was very aesthetically rich. He absolutely nailed it. The biker theme, the hard strings on the album, it felt like the second song on the album felt like a Tony Hawk Pro Skater song. And that made me put him into a different category than all of these other artists, because if you're able to do that and conceptualize it and then also be able to feed it to your fans and have them digest it and it go positively, in my eyes, you're on a different level than a lot of these guys. So that's pretty much the concept of this entire video. Hope that you guys enjoyed it. Me and Noah will be back on for regular scheduled programming this week talking about sports. But yes, thank you guys very much. I love to do this, and I'm gonna see what else we can do. Me and Noah might do some more, do a little bit more editing, add a little bit more into these videos. We're almost a year in, so I'm gonna be trying a lot more. But yeah, thank you guys, and I hope everybody liked it. Have a good one. Audio Jungle.